गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑन लैंडस्केपिंग ऑफ होम ग्राउंड। लैंडस्केपिंग एज इट इज डन फॉर लार्जर स्टेट्स और पब्लिक पार्क्स कैन ऑल्सो बी इम्प्लीमेंटेड इन अ टेस्टफुल एंड आर्टिस्टिक वे फॉर अ स्मॉल होम ग्राउंड। दो ऑन अ स्मॉलर स्केल द सिंपलेस्ट डेफिनेशन ऑफ स्मॉल एज सजेस्टेड बाई सम अथर्स क्वाइट अप्रोप्रिएटली is an area which can be effectively managed and maintained physically as well as financially by the owner and his family with occasional hired labor for such hard work as digging, moving and shearing of hedges. Here ways will be suggested for landscaping only small residential houses. For larger estates, a combination of landscaping effects suggested for parks and home landscaping may be followed. Basic guidelines for a home landscape. The personal preference plays a considerable role in developing a home garden. The home, including its surroundings, should be an outward expression of the inner personality and individuality of the owner. It is advisable to think a lot before even a single digging work starts. Basic principles before actually drawing the master plan. The following points should be kept in mind in home landscaping. Background. The background in a garden, whether a wall, tall trees or a hedge, should be neutral in nature. That is to say, this should not become a distracting feature over the main features of the garden. Contrast. The designs should be such that it should break monotony. To achieve this, variation in form, texture or color has to be brought in. It is very important to develop contrast in the home ground. Balance or proportion. A balance has to be maintained between different components, masses, form, color, etc. of a garden. Overcrowding of plants or other garden features should be avoided. So you should develop your home ground in uniqueness. Principles of landscape gardening. First one is open center. The central area of the garden should be left out of any items of major interest. The best way to achieve this is to have a lawn, which also gives an effect of largeness to the property. A specimen shrub in the center of the lawn is unsuitable as this counters the principles of spaciousness. But a tree branching at higher levels from the ground could be planted. Second one is repetition. The repetition or duplicating some features of a garden helps to achieve rhythm, balance and unity. In a formal garden, generally the same feature is repeated, but for an informal design this need not be so. Here one may repeat the color tone without disturbing the texture, form or quantity. If there is a circular path, this can be repeated by having two or three consecutive circular shaped beds of annual flowers, hedges and savory border. Thus, though the shape is repeated, the variation in texture, color and form ensure that the design doesn't look monotonous. Fourth one is rhythm. A landscape designer should have an artistic sense to understand how to bring in rhythm in the design. Arranging the different elements haphazardly without harmony does not enhance beauty. Harmonious lines, often artistically curved, bring in rhythm to the landscape. A group of shrubs in front of a rockery breaks the rhythm. Repetition of certain elements such as form enhances the rhythm. Variety. To break the monotony in a garden, variety is essential. This is achieved by contrast of color, form and texture. Besides these, designs should be simple, easy to maintain and provide comfort for inmates. Making a plan. If the garden area is sufficiently large, this can be divided into three areas. First one is approach or public area. This is the area from the street side extending to the entrance of the house. The approach area should not be overcrowded with large trees. It is better to have doorway or foundation plantings with low growing shrubs and evergreens. Big trees, if space permits, can go in the backyard but should not be overcrowded in the front. But a few low growing trees can be accommodated at the appropriate places as next to entrance. If a space is available or somewhere in the front lawn, an open spacious lawn with some annuals, zinnias, salvias and petunias or herbaceous perennials, chrysanthemums, canna, impatience, insect can be planned in addition to the foundation plantings. Second, work or service area. Where your feasible, this and the living area should be situated at the back of the house as these need privacy. This area includes the kitchen garden, compost bin, nursery, tool shed and garage. Private garden area or living area. In the Western countries, this is generally termed as the outdoor living area where people sit out in the winter to enjoy the sun or rest in the summer under an arbor or shade of tree. This area should be easily approachable and visible from the living, drawing room or dining room, screened from unsightly objects and for privacy. In the Western countries, people prefer a terrace and this is the place where it should come. There should be some shaded setting spots such as tree or arbor with garden benches, a side stretch of land with shrub border or few annuals beds or a rose garden can also be included in this section. A tennis court or a play area has to be included here. If there is enough room, many people advise not to include any pool or formal rock garden or the kind in a home garden, but there's no harm if a formal or informal lily pool can fit in with the overall design, with or without a fountain or a rock garden. A statue or sundial can also be well fitted in some spacious compounds. A doorway near the house needs special attention as this is the space which receives maximum attention from a visitor. Depending upon the approach, a doorway can be planted informally, formally, or in a semi-informal pattern. It can be arranged with a garden type design consisting of an ornamental set or flowering tree, perennial and annual flowers, climbing roses, some bulbs such as geranthus, amaryllis and daffodils for temperate regions. A bed of roses can also be a spot of beauty provided it receives the morning sun. Symmetrical paths, plants with pyramidal form such as thuja, juniperus, chinensis and cupressus macrocarpa are preferred by many near the doorway for a formal treatment. It is suitable for small gardens. Bahunias in different species are quite suitable. Bottle brush is suitable for many situations. Trichoma argentea, Cassia fistula and Cassia spectabilis, cherries, prunus, sargentii, weeping willow, Salix babylonica and Salix purpurea variety pendula are also very ornamental. Some shrubs like Ixora singaporensis, Mosenda philippica, Azalea etc. are also suitable for home garden. Thank you for patient hearing.